Rajendran here, joining from Market Calls, and welcome everyone to how to trade intraday using Market Profile. So in today's topic, we want to discuss on Market Profile here. So before getting into the session, just give me a quick confirmation about the audio and video quality. And as usual, the session is getting recorded, and the recorded video will be available for viewing once the session is completed. So there is a chat box is there. You can go and give the confirmation over there. If it is yes, the audio or video quality is good, you can simply type yes in the chat box so that I can have a fair idea that things are looking good before getting into the session. All right, thanks Nitish, Venkatesh, Prasanna, Rod, Mohit, Ganesh, and everybody. So without any further delay, let me get into the session here. A little bit about me. My name is Rajendran. I'm the founder of Market Calls and co-founder of AlgoMojo. I've been trading this market since 2006 onwards. And so far, my core expertise, I can say like most of my core expertise is on three topics. One is on automated trading, and another one is market profile and order flow. I've been actively practicing market profile and order flow since 2012 onwards, and automated trading and systematic trading since 2009 onwards. So in today's agenda, what we are going to discuss is we are going to discuss about price action versus price distribution, how to prepare for intraday trading, and how to use market profile to identify intraday nuances, and how to identify intraday trend reversal using market profile, and the importance of the developing market structure. So this is what we are going to discuss in today's discussion here. And before getting into that, a little bit of basics. I just want to know how many of you are very, very new to market profile, or you can put your market profile experience in years, how long you've been using market profile. If you are new, you just simply type new, or if you're already using market profile, you can simply type, let's say 6 months, you can type 6 months, or if it is 2 years, you can type 2 years, or 5 years, you can simply type 5 years. Ramesh is saying new, Mohit is new, Anju is 6 months, Pradeep is 1 year, and Ganesh is 1 year, and Trade Guru is new. So, and Deepak, yeah, Deepak also using market profile. He's also very new to market profile. Ravi is new. Well and good. Ganesh is also new. Sunil is also new. So if you ask me what is market profile, I would say like market profile is completely different from all the technical indicators. In fact, market profile is not a technical indicator at all. Market profile, it is more of a visual based approach. You can see, you have to see the market profile, and then from the market profile, we can understand what is happening inside the markets. It is not Elliott wave. Definitely, it is not going to be a GAN or let us say Fibonacci kind of things. It will not give you levels. Of course, market profile shows you a lot many things. Market profile is generally a visualization tool. It helps traders to understand what is happening inside the markets. It helps the traders to understand the trader's behavior, not only the trader's behavior, but also the price behavior also. So in market profile, we focus more on the price distribution. What I've been using here is I've been using a market profile in two ways. Let me go and pull up my whiteboard over here. So basically, there are two ways we can use market profile. One is a micro focus, and another one is a macro focus. So one is a macro focus. This is what which is taught in books, which is available in the books. It talks mostly about the profile structure. It talks about the structure, and it talks about the nuances surrounding the structures. However, when it comes to intraday perspective, and when it comes to the intraday perspective, what is more important is micro focus. largely wherever you go, they'll be talking about only the structures. They'll be talking about P-shaped structure, B-shaped structure, D-shaped structures, and Q-shaped structures, all kind of structures they'll be talking about. How the structure, how the bell curve shape of the market profile. The bell curve shape of the market profile is the beauty of the market profile itself. However, when it comes to intraday trading, we need even more in-depth analysis. We need a micro focus towards the market profile. So generally, the micro focus towards the market profile, it talks not about the structure. It talks about the developing structure. Developing structure. Whereas macro focus talks about developed structure. Already the structure has been developed. Already the structure has been developed. Let's say yesterday's activity, how the yesterday's activity was looking like. Developing structure. Whereas here we talk about intraday references. References, visual references. I can tell you one thing, this micro focus is more of a modern way of thinking. Modern way of thinking. In fact, Jim Dalton had placed a lot of effort in explaining all these micro focus. Most of the Jim Dalton's sessions, if you go and attend, you can see this kind of micro level focus. Very tiny piece of information they'll be using for market analysis for intraday trading purpose. Macro focus is mostly used for short-term trading. So what we are going to analyze in this particular structure is that how one should learn the micro focus. So what are the information they have to focus on? There are various levels. From a micro focus level, one have to give more importance to such kind of levels. Let me go to market profile first of all, and then I'll show you. First of all, we'll go and get some basics of market profile, and then we'll quickly jump into the micro level focus. As I said, this micro level focus is what very important to analyze the developing structure, to understand the intraday references and visual references. That is where the core importance has to be provided. So I'll go back to the basics here. So generally, market profile is a tool which helps not only intraday traders, but also short-term traders also to effectively understand the market as a crowd, how it is doing. Will market profile give buy signal or sell signal? If you ask me, market profile will not give. Market profile throws a lot of information. So what as a trader that we have to do here is, let me tell you what is the process that we have to do. Market profile, as I said, will not give you direct buy or direct sell. Market profile will not give you. Market profile, it generates, we call it as a MGI. MGI stands for market generated information. Using this market generated information, tiny piece of information, it will be keep on generating. So these kind of tiny piece of information, we can use this to analyze the markets. We can use it to build a view. We can use it to build a view in our markets, which side you are anticipating, whether price will go up or go down, why it will be going up or why it will be going down. That is what we call as a context. Remember, the context is not a trade. It helps. The market generated view is set of information. It keeps on throwing that information. It helps you to build the view. Now from the view, what we can do? We can wait for the trade location. So wait for trade location. So one such trade is what I'm going to explain. Wait for trade location. Now once you identify the trade location, the next part is all about execution. Trade execution. When the right setup is happened, you go for a trade, and then we learn to manage the trade. That's what it's all about, the trade management. It's all about. And then we'll continue monitoring the trades. We monitor the trades, monitor for continuation. Again, we look into the MGI. Again, we'll build a view. If there is any change in the view, we will be go for the trade management. So it is a routine process over here. If the view is changing, it obviously it impacts your trade management decisions straight away. So it is a continuous process one have to adopt during the intraday trading cycle. All right. So let me go back simply to the basics of market profile. First of all, you need to know what kind of traders we are competing. We can classify all the traders and investors into four major categories. One is day time frame traders. They are nothing but the intraday traders. And short term traders, intermediate traders and long term traders. These are the four categories. Long term and intermediate term, they belong to the investors category. Whereas the day time frame and shorter time frame traders, they belong to the trading category over here. Is that any audio issues are there? If you're facing any audio issues, you can close it and then you can reconnect it back. Okay, a couple of people are saying like there are no audio issues. Of course, I'm on a high speed internet. Let me show you. I hope I'm in a high speed internet here. Yeah, so we are on the high speed internet. So quality of the internet is pretty much good for the day. Anyways, coming back to the topic. So we learned these are the different types of traders. We know what a day time frame trader will do. They come intraday and then they close their positions by intraday itself. And then short term traders, they are big traders generally. However, the size they are dealing with their positions, the positions are way big compared to what we are expecting. Something like 100 lots, they have the capacity to trade 100 lots. Or even they can manage the positions like even hundreds of crores worth of positions they can manage. But still they are traders, they are not investors. And intermediate and long-term investors are mostly from the institutional background. They focus more on macro levels, fundamentals. However, day time frame and short-term traders, they focus majorly on levels. Every trader, they have some level to monitor. Typically, traders are the one they trade the levels. Some traders, they trade technical pattern. End of the day, they will narrow down to the levels only. And many traders, they trade the swing high, swing low breakouts. And some traders, they trade multi-day breakouts. Some investors, they trade multi-month breakouts or multi-year breakouts. So somehow traders are very much obsessed with the levels. Most of the traders are obsessed with the levels, especially even big traders also. Precisely big traders are obsessed with the levels, which you can see visually using market profile. Market profile is more of a visualization tool to see where the traders are entering precisely at such kind of levels. So here is a profile structure. What you're seeing is like some of the important information that you can retrieve from there. So there is a concept called value area. Value area talks about where most of the price action is getting traded in terms of time. So how we are getting a time as an element over here, that is the beauty of market profile. Market profile focus on not only price, but also on time and volume as well. So price, time and volume is another word we call it as a TPO. TPO stands for time and price and opportunity. Opportunity means volume. So market profile itself a study about not only about price, but not only about volume, but also about time as well. So this is how the market profile structure looks like. There are two profile you can see that simultaneously. One is the market profile, which talks about price distribution, and there is a volume profile is there. So market profile is composed of letters, whereas volume profile, you can see histograms, horizontal histograms that you can see over here. Volume profile talks about how much volume is getting traded at any given level for the day overall. So every day you'll be getting a profile structure. Let me show you one of the day's activity. I'll go and simulate our day's activity over here. So this is Nifty Futures, April month contract. I'll go and simulate the one of the day's contract over here. So I'll go and simulate 13th April activity because it is a very interesting day. Every day you'll be getting a structure. One day, there'll be only one structure only. But within that structure, this is a macro level focus. If you're studying the structure, how the structure is looking like, that is more of a macro focus. But what I am talking is a micro focus, how the activity, how the structure itself developing. Is it weaker? Is it stronger? So let's go and study the 13th April activity over here. I'm going to simulate the price action of 13th April. So I'll go and disconnect my data feed. I'll go and connect to my playback connection. So using playback connection, we can very easily simulate any particular day structure. So I'm going to simulate the structure of 13th April, which is, I think, last Tuesday. So here is the thing. I'll go and simulate 13th April. So one should be able to see the structure over here. Let me zoom it out also. Now, what is happening here is, when you are looking into the structure, previous day, what happened, that is also more important. And what is more important is where price is opening relation to the yesterday's activity. So you can see that previous day, what one can see here is, one can see a gaps. You can see a lot of gaps in between the structure. The gaps is what we call as anomalies. There are a lot of anomalies you can see over here. So which is what I had indicated as an emotional selling. News-based emotional selling. You know why this Monday there was a strong drop. Almost 500 points drop happened, right? Why the drop happened? Everything was going well on Friday. However, all in a sudden, price started dropping down on Monday because most of the states are getting into partial lockdown or complete lockdown. So those kind of measures has been going on, particularly Maharashtra. There is an announcement likely from the chief minister that Maharashtra might get into a lockdown, and most of the states curfew has been imposed. Complete night curfew has been imposed over here. Coronavirus wave two has been increasing. However, how I see the structure is from the structure, as I said, it is more of a macro focus. The macro focus talks about the emotions of the traders. So from the structure itself, I can see that a lot of anomalies are there. That means a more emotional selling is happening. All the sellings are because of the news-based emotional selling. You know that most of the news-based emotional selling pulls back up. If somebody was trading the price, right, what they would have done, they also part of the selling because price was going down. Many people, they see the price and they trade the price alone. That is mostly not a good idea. You know that. Mostly it is not a good idea at all. So what one have to do over there is they have to step away. They have to understand that the macro focuses, that is macro focus always talks about the emotions. So the sellers are the one who had done this, all this selling, but however, the job of the sellers are not really good. It is not a good selling at all. According to me, when there are more poor structures are there, it is one form of a emotional selling only. So usually the very next day, most of the time, market have the tendency to pull back and clear the emotional references. Not necessarily it has to clear the very same day. However, majority of the time, maybe in terms of 65% of the time, we can say like the greater majority, generally such kind of poor structures will be repaired back. When I say repaired back, what does that mean? What does that mean is price have the tendency to go back and trade around those references, wherever the anomalies are there. So these are the places anomalies are there. So these are the places one can expect price to come back and repair. Majority of the time, 65% of the time, we can expect a repair can happen. When I say repair, price can again go back and trade around those references. Is that a only intraday references? If you ask me, that is not a micro focus at all. Micro focus is all about closely monitoring the price action. So here I'm just running the price action here. Let me go and increase by 3 times. So I'm just increasing the price action by 3 times. You can see that wherever the price is moving on, the price action will be plotted with letters. Every half an hour, a letter is going to get generated. And every half an hour, a new letter is going to born. Wherever the price is moving fresh, you're going to see the price new letters will be getting generated. There is a small hash letter is there. That hash letter tracks the last traded price. And the O letter, O represents today's open, where the market opened today. Where the market opening is very, very important over here, because price is opening inside the day's range and it is trying to repair. Initially, price tried to dip down. There was a strong downtrend happened over here at the opening. Price opened and then it went deeply, some almost 80 points down, and quickly pulled back and it started moving on the opposite side. Usually these kind of setups are bullish in nature majority of the time. Majority of the time, if you would have seen that, most of the traps, bear traps are made from an intraday perspective. Price opens, it drops and quickly rises back. How many times you would have seen that? As if it gives an impression that, oh my God, this market is going to crash. That is the kind of intention it gives, but all of a sudden it rises back and it starts moving throughout the day. That this is one such day that we are seeing over here. Now, these kind of price actions are, you'll be seeing a very early reversal. Opening, it will give an impression that this market is going to fall through. But once again, now the price has been, you can see that the price, the opening has been, price from the open, it went down, but again, it pulls back immediately and it started moving up. It never come back and trade through the open, not much of a times. That open would have been tested very less amount of time. Majority of the time, price have the intention to go back and it keeps on moving up and up and up. Now let us see how the price action is happening. You can see that the time, you can see it over here. Letter A period will be running from 9:15 to 9:45. So by 9:45, we will be shifting to B period. B period will be running from 9:45 to 10:15. Let us see how the B period is happening over here. You know, you have a watch on the time as well and have a look into the price action also. So it starts with the price action. Slowly we'll be start monitoring the price distribution also. As of now, nothing was happening. Price was opening above the, I mean, it opened, it went down and it started rising back and trading above the today's open. Where is the today's open? So here is the today's open. This level represents the today's open. Let's see, it's still the slow price action. Almost we have, it's about to change to the B period. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to increase the price action by 6 times. So I'm going to increase the speed of the price action here, because if I go at this rate, it will move for another 2.5 hours. It'll be keep on running. So B period started. B period also started moving. So there are two profiles you can see over here. One is the normal profile. It's a regular profile, And another one is a split profile. The split profile is more for the intraday users, So even if you're somebody is taking a positional trade also, but they want more clarity about that particular day, they can obviously watch the split profile. So looking into the structures, you can see that the auction is still on the higher side. Price is not at all bending down below the open. If at all it is running through the open, then the chances of going sideways was very higher. As of now, it haven't gone through the open at all. Let me increase the speed also simultaneously so that we'll be able to scale it a bit faster. So I'll increase the speed to 10 times over here. I'm just increasing. That means every second, 10 seconds of market activity is getting passed. See that the day high, this high is not a good high at all. So what happened is that suddenly the B period had come and made the fresh day high. So let's keep on making a fresh day high. The price action is still continuing. I'll just increase the speed further to 15 times, probably 15 times. It's a very interesting observation. B period, still the auction is keep on going on. What is happening here is all those anomalies, whichever it is carry forwarding from yesterday's price action, most of the anomalies got a clearance. So if at all there are four anomalies or more than four anomalies, we call that as a poor structure. So that is what we call as a what? Poor structure. So the poor structure has been totally repaired back, poor structures. So prices started moving totally against the weaker hands. Yesterday's sellers are mostly more of a weaker hands, more of an emotional news-based panicking sellers. You know, right? Panic sellers rarely makes money in the markets. Whoever panicking, very rarely they make money in the market. Majority of the times, price moves against the emotional traders. Probably one can go back and check back their trading history itself. Wherever the traders, they panicked, more majority of the time they had probably taken the bad decisions. Such kind of bad decisions the sellers had taken on 12th April. Now notice here, time is 10:12. So another 3 seconds, the letter C period is about to come to an end over here. The C period is about to come to an end. Notice something crazy is going to happen over here. What is the C period? The C period came, let me pass the session here. Okay. So what happening here is, this is what I call it as a micro focus. Notice this letter. The B and C period is exactly same. It's exactly same and the price is precisely stopping at that level. Each and every letter what I am using here is a 2-point TPO. So I'm using a 2-point TPO over here, TPO. And this high is what we called as a weaker high. Let's call this WH. WH means weaker high. Weaker high. Now when these kind of weaker high is happening, generally the traders, big traders will be coming and selling these markets. You know that a lot of single prints are there. The B period, a lot of single prints are there. Notice the single prints. A lot of single prints are there. So precisely some traders are coming, stepping in, and they have started selling this market. Usually, very rarely market leaves a single print as a clue in the markets. So what one can expect is that traders are coming and selling this market. Maybe they try to close this single print gap. Usually single print, if you could see that single prints are the, if you ask me what is a single print are single price levels, which is very rarely it forms. Here, if you would have seen even in this entire structure, emotional structure, we never able to see single prints in between the profile. However, there are a lot of single prints over here, single letters are there, which is very rare in nature. So usually from an intraday perspective, more buyers would have been went long, long and long and long and long. So generally some traders will turn themselves and they turn already probably a lot of buyers onboarded, a lot of buyers onboarded over here. Now some of the buyers would have been in a deep profits. They should have been started booking the profits over here from an intraday perspective. They are traders whoever went probably taken over long over here. Generally, they could have turned themselves into sellers. Once you are a buyer, next you are a what? Seller. So they are the one who trade the levels very precisely. They start converting themselves into sellers. These are not new sellers. They are level-based sellers. They see that price is taking a fresh high. Exactly from the fresh high, they are coming and selling. And they are mostly traders in nature as well. They are mostly traders in nature. So look at the price action here. That is a this is a micro level focus, two micro level focus that we are making over here. One is the weaker high. Number one, this is a weaker high. Number two, there is a single print zones. Single print zones. All these are market generated information on the developing structure. Structure is getting developed. Still, the structure is not completely formed. More or less around mid of the day, the structure would have been come to one shape. But at this point of time, structure is very, very young for the day. So you have to learn to give more of importance to the price action, which is the micro focus over here. But going forward, you have to give more importance to the price action also, price distribution also. At the opening, there are no price distribution. Opening itself, you will not get a price distribution. Opening, what you will be getting is a price action. So far, whatever that we are monitoring is just only a price action only. So if you are watching the price action, you have to give more importance to the visual information. So what is the visual information saying? The visual information is saying here that traders are precisely taking an entry over here. Precisely coming and taking entry over here. That is what we call as a weaker high. So which is what? A very important reference. From an intraday perspective, a very short scalping trade is possible. Immediately, you should consider taking a shot over here. My view for that day is like immediately you should consider taking a shot over here. However, later some point in time, if there is enough opportunity is there, let's say markets are all trading something like this, one should go and look for a long trade as well. That is how one have to position in this kind of markets. Precisely, very interesting kind of opportunities. These kind of opportunities repeatedly happens in the markets. So you can use this to build a context. You can understand what kind of, how the price action is most likely to be. Probably you'll be having such kind of hunch you'll be always getting when you started focusing on the micro focus level. As I said, these are modern approaches towards the markets. Let us see how the price action went over here. So if you're seeing here, that high is still defended. And letter C period started coming down. Very precisely, they got stopped. Don't ask me, does it happens every day? It doesn't happens every day. But in a month, you can expect one or two such kind of setups. You always market throw such kind of setups. Many times we had seen that kind of setups. And many times you can convert that trades into a trading opportunity also. You can see that still letter 2 points is left for the all those single prints got a closure. Now look at the another nuances over here. Now more and more activity is happening around these levels. This is where the more number of activity in terms of time, 3 times is what? So now my focus shifted towards the structure. Initially, I was focusing on the price action and the visual nuances. Now I'm just focusing on the structure. Now it is like 3 times. Now I'm having a thought process. My thought process is like, what if more and more time is going to spend around these levels? We know that markets are very volatile. So market can show a lot of volatility in the markets. Day high is weaker. So day high is weak. Day high is weak. That is one information we got about that. Price is slided down. And more activity is started happening. That means maybe more and more activity can happen around these levels. Something like this can happen. This is what the core focus is. So at this point of time, I have to wait for another trading opportunity set up. Definitely there is a very good, interesting opportunities building up towards the day high. Anytime I can expect a price to go and hit the day high, because majority of the time, the day high is weaker over here. Now the price action, you can see that almost 4 times it started building up over here. The center point is getting more and more bulkier. It's getting bulged repeatedly. That particular price is getting traded like a magnet. So that is what a point of control is all about, right? The point of control, we call it as a POC. It often acts like a magnet. Letter D period also started. Letter D period runs from 10:45 to 11:15. Likewise, in a day, you'll be getting almost 15 letters. So you know that day high is weaker, price is sliding down. Again, fear is getting built in. Yesterday, there was a news-based selling. Now again, more and more if you see the price alone, it is very difficult to play in an objective manner. If you don't know the context that day high is weaker. What people will do, price has been slided almost from 11,480, it slided to almost 11,380 levels. Let's go and sell. This is what the general consensus. Selling is good, but you should step away from the right thing. If you are a seller, you should step away because the day high is not stronger at all. Now, what is happening here is price again plunging through the open here, plunged through the open, and again it got a pullback above. Monitoring the around the trading and monitoring the trades around the open itself are very important clues again. That is also one form of an micro level focus, because traders, many traders, they'll be trading around the open many at times. You can see that the B period went down, C period also going down. But still, what we can expect here is that more and more trading activity can happen either here or here, because this is where almost four times of activity happened, almost here three times of activity happened. So the point of control, which is the fair price for the day, can be building around those levels. So far, markets also sliding down. Letter B, letter C, letter D, letter E, all are in a falling mode only. C, D, E is totally falling. So these kind of places, I would wait for the market to stop its fall, let the fall get arrested, and then let that some nuances get built in. We know that price can go to the center point. Center point is somewhere over here. This is where more times of activity is getting spent. And we know that day high test is also can happen because day high is weaker. So what is still happening? Still the auction is still going down only. What is the important reference over here from the intraday perspective? Generally, what is the today's low? Today's low is over here. This is a one important reference to monitor. Sometimes they will try to go down and then they'll cheat around those levels and then they'll come back sometimes. I'm just waiting for that. Is that something like that? It's happening or not? But that haven't happened at all. They came very closer to the day low, but they haven't done anything around that day low at all. They've given an impression that markets has been falling, but we know that markets are generally prone to do a two-way auction process. Usually these kind of things, you can see that price is coming outside the value area. Price coming outside the value area again, more and more. What is happening here is more and more emotional sellers are the one who go and sell down below the value area. This is value area low. Anything down below the value area low, still they are not able to get the day low and the price is pulling back again into the value area. It is more of an emotional intraday sellers. More of a what? Emotional intraday sellers. Intraday sellers. Now you know that C is falling, D is also falling, E is also falling. Letter F is also still not clarity yet, but F is also more or less it is falling only. So C, D, E, F, it is falling on the downside. So there is no confirmation yet about this fall, that the fall is still not yet arrested. We can consider that fall has been arrested if that any of the high, let's say F period high has been taken out by G period, then we can consider that the downfall has been arrested. So one have to wait for that structure to go for a long. So definitely a very good trading opportunity is getting building around these levels. Approximately some 100 plus points from a intraday perspective. So let me pause and show you what was my thought process on that particular day. So 13th, right? 13th. This is, so we have a Slack community where we keep on talking about the market activity. a lot of discussions will be happening in the markets here. So this is one day before. We are having an bearish thoughts, right? So Monday, we thought like a Nifty focus towards monthly low. 14261 is the immediate downside focus. That is what the view on Monday morning when there was a panic news was hitting in. So we also went into the sell side. So then around 1227, when most of the downside has been done, right? So I have to go neutral. One of the trader was asking why you are going neutral. Markets are falling. So maybe more fall could arise over there. But however, we not only depend upon market profile, there are some of the supporting tools I'll be using over here. It is indicating that it is an extreme exhaustion is there. Most likely, it could be more of an emotional selling. It is an indication that more of an emotional selling. In the previous times, such kind of emotional exhaustion had brought a pullback. So this time also, I was waiting for a pullback. I was waiting for the market to settle down. So I thought like, let me go neutral over here. I don't want to hold out with any bearish thoughts. If any proper buying opportunity is happening, I just want to go with an... So hence exiting the shorts in NF will revise later on. That's what I said. Like, so I don't want to go. I don't want to carry forward with that emotional thoughts within me because I'm seeing that it's a news-based selling. Everyone knows that, whole world knows that. So it is a publicly available information. Publicly available information means not much of an edge is there. And mostly your indicators also indicating that it is an oversold phenomena. Market profile structure, end of the day, it indicated that it is a poor structure. So price at the opening, it started moving against the poor structure over here. And that is the most important thing. So my comment is like, I don't want to get stuck in a emotional shorts. This was my comment. Then, so what I was expecting is that odds of a balanced market with the day high is a weaker. Day high is a weaker. This comment is around 11 o'clock, the day high. So B and C, the high is what weaker. I was also seeing like there is a price action over here. ABCD is widening. So more and more focus can shift towards around those levels. So this is a real trading process that I we've been adapting on a daily basis. Daily basis, we monitor the structure and then we will be trying to understand which level is weaker, which level is not weaker. So there are a lot of various weaker levels are there, almost close to some 10 to 12 weaker levels are there. By looking into the structure, it gives us a fair idea why you should not go and short these markets. If you're shorting, it's fine. If you're shorting, one should step away from the game, make money and then step away from that. And then one should start looking for a long opportunity. That's how the focus on that particular day was all about. So then what happened over here? So then... then Nifty is one time framing against one time framing is a high confidence indication. This is the view that we are taking around 134. Let's go to 134 and let's see what kind of setup happened around 134. Almost we are at 12 o'clock. So 12 o'clock around 130, I was having a view that Nifty could test the day high. So the expectation here is Nifty is having day high testing odds. This view is coming around 130. Let me explain why that Nifty could go and test the day high testing odds. Let me run over here. Time is at 12 o'clock. So 130 is what I'm having a view that you should go along over here. First of all, I was waiting for this downfall to get arrested over here. Still the downfall is there. Letter C, D, E, F, all are falling down, which is one time framing. It's one form of a seller confidence. That seller confidence has to go away so that I can start trading my trading opportunity. So C, D, E, everything is falling. Straight away, it's keep on falling down here. You see that C is also falling, D is also falling, E period, F period also falling down. And moreover, we know that point of control is staying over here, not migrated much. If at all my point of control can stay, it can be, these are the two places point of control can happen. So that means odds of pulling back to the center is always a possibility. Because as I said, intraday point of control often acts like a magnet. G period started. Still, G period haven't broken at all. Almost time is almost 12:30. Still haven't broken the day high of F period yet. Here is the F period. Let me mark the F period so that when it happening, we know that that high has been taken out. So what I am trying to do is I'm just waiting for the trade location to happen. Probably I'm not sure whether if, what if G period also falls. So I was waiting for that something to happen. Then what happened is G period came back and broken the one time framing. So this is one indication that yes, you can go for the long opportunity, but still I waited. Still I waited for some more setups to happen. I just want to wait for one more one time framing to happen and then the one time framing to break. So what so far happened here is the C period started going down, D period also going down, E is also going down, F period started going down. And then you see that the E period went down even more down. So compared to E, F period low was higher and then G period low is also higher. So E, F, G, it was kind of one time framing on the upside. The G period also started coming back. You can see that the center point is over here. Price is returning back to the center point. See that price returned back to the center point. And now this is a two-way auction process where more time is also getting spent over here. Now we can see that almost 6 times price activity has been spent around those levels. Now H also started going up. This is a very good indication. Usually one can wait for the one-time framing to break. So I was waiting for some time. If at all price falls down, I'm just willing to look for a long opportunity to trade towards the day high. Now that is what I've been waiting. Still, I waited. I was watching this price action. The price action was building very good, but still I waited for my trade setup. So this kind of one time framing is what we call it as a midday one time framing. Usually it is a bullish trading opportunity. One should be positioning themselves into the long side. I was waiting. I was waiting till 1:30. So I was waiting for this balance to get over because I know more and more time based balancing can happen around these levels. Because that was the expectation. I was expecting first half to get into a balancing mode. There are a lot of nuances also you could find over here. You can see that the C period center point is exactly the H period. That means H period high is also weaker. BC is weaker. So a lot of weaker shots are coming in. So this is a weaker shots. Here are some weaker shots. And here a positive development that the one time framing is there. Still that H period is coming precisely over here. You see that this H period also weaker because it's exactly at the A period. A period halfback. There is a small white color letter, which is the halfback letter. So the H period also, it was weaker and then it got broken out, but still it is weaker. You can see that it's at, now it's at E period half back levels. Still this H period low is weaker. So very precisely that H period low got broken down. Now there is no weakness over there. Not much of a weakness. And it started focusing around, time is getting very close to. So I thought like probably this is the right time to look for a long opportunity to trade towards the two levels. So now we have two major levels over here. One is the point of control. So point of control is more or less either here or can be here. This is a view right from the start. And H period is weaker, B and C is weaker. So one can expect a straight price action towards around those levels. That is the view we got around 1:30. So one should go and trade the intraday perspective to look for a longer opportunity over here. Still the price was oscillating. It got a dip and then it pulled back again. So the decision has been taken over here. Once the dip has been done and then a pullback happened, thought like, okay, maybe we should look for a longer opportunity over here. My entry was around 14,365. then I period scale back in, again price was back to the center, right? This is what we thought about, right? So probably the point of control may be here, either here or here, because almost equal amount of activity is getting developed over here. At this point of time, almost 6 TPOs over here and 7 TPOs over here. 7 letters has been traded. 7 times the price is getting traded over. That itself are nuances. That is a micro focus level. This is a micro focus. This is not a macro focus. This is a micro focus on the structure. So we know that more and more time can get developed, the chances of price coming back is very, very higher. The E period low is emotional intraday selling. Emotional intraday selling. And we should start focusing on the weaker levels. So I had precisely taken time. My entry point was exactly at 1:30. That particular day, I had done only 2 trades. One of the trade is in ICC Bank. And then I taken a positional long over there. And here I took a intraday long here because the opportunity was set in right. The nuances are aligned over here. Odds has been improved that the loss, the selling has been arrested. That is where the focus has been shifted towards the longs. So I was expecting this B and C to get taken out from an intraday perspective. The test has been done. The odds of, generally from an intraday perspective, these kind of odds will be taken out probably we can say like the 75% odds that these kind of nuances will get cleared on the very same date. So 75 to 80% odds, you can say like. When your conviction is great, one can go and take a directional view itself. Directional view, one can go and trade in options, in naked, they can play with the naked options or hedged futures is what generally I prefer to trade over here. Hedged futures means you will take a futures and you hedge it with an out of the money option. So later on, price has been went up, but my view that for that particular day is though we are bullish, I was not extraordinarily bullish for the day. So when the day high is tested, I stepped away from the game for that particular day. But however, market went a little bit higher. I think it went to somewhere around 14,540 kind of levels. It went on the upside. So however, my view is like to trade only towards the day high only. So day high test is done. So that was the view. So day high test is done. 2 o'clock. It took only half an hour to scale back. And then I also said why you should not follow when the sentiment is negative. Everything is negative. Why we should not step away from the game. Again, I went, my view has been, went into a neutral mode. That means I don't have any opinion in the markets again. Maybe we'll get back. Though I'm having a bullish odds, though my hunch was that I should trade only the bullish view, I stepped away from the markets. I was looking for an further long opportunity or whatever the opportunity which is coming in. So I thought of trading such kind of opportunities. So this is one form of a micro level focus. So every day you'll be encountering a lot of micro level focus over here. So how to trade such kind of days, how to spot those nuances. First of all, one have to learn all those nuances. Once you learned, then next is practicing those nuances, preparing for the markets. That is the most important thing. First of all, before looking into this, one should start preparing for the markets. So how to prepare for the markets? Let's say on Monday's trading activity. Let me go to the recent scenario over here. Prior to that, we'll try to complete some of the basics of market profile. I hope now you get a fair idea what is a macro level focus and what is a micro level focus. Macro level focus is for preparing, trying to get the context, overall context before starting your trades. Micro level information will actually meaningful insights to tackle from an intraday perspective. That is the one which is going to give a real edge from an intraday trading. Some people use structures, but structures, to my knowledge, definitely it gives a pretty good idea about at the macro level only it gives an idea. But from an intraday level perspective, one have to shift their focus more towards at a very micro perspective. That is what market profile helps you to achieve that. So let's go a little bit further. You know that there are days you'll be getting a prominent point of control. There are days you'll be getting only point of control. The difference is like if the point of control is less than 10, we call it a simple, normal, regular point of control. If it is more than 9 or 10, we call it a prominent point of control. In fact, last Friday, let me go back to the last Friday. Last Friday, we got a prominent point of control. Always prominent point of control is a macro level information, right? It is not a micro level focus. At times it will be a micro level focus also, but at the end of the day, now market has been ended. So you'll be getting a clear macro level perspective about the markets. Last Friday, Nifty ended with the prominent point of control. So which is going to be a very important information going for Monday's preparation. So generally at a micro level, we will be giving more importance to the levels because these are the places more weaker hands will be coming and trading around those levels. Sometimes traders will be coming around trading at today's open. Sometimes early morning high, early morning low. So early morning high and low is nothing but the A period, first half an hour high and low. Sometimes they'll be coming and trading around the previous day high or previous day low or previous day half back, intra bar half back, prominent point of control. So these are some of the intraday level one have to give more focus to that. Sometimes it could be a half back levels also. That's why I mentioned the previous day half back and today's half back, that is intra bar half back. So both the half backs are very important micro focused levels. Now, even if you look into the last Friday's data, right? Let me go to the last Friday's data. We could have seen such kind of levels. So if you could see these levels, the M period low, price was crashing in the last 45 minutes. Price crashed to the low and that low was precisely at the A period high, which is nothing but the previous day high. 15th April high and the M period low, the difference is hardly only one TPOs only. Precisely the selling stopped exactly at the previous day high. So somebody was keep on selling till the previous day high and then they stopped their selling. So some people, they had done a selling, they kept on selling, they stopped their selling exactly at the previous day high. Then we know that who is doing such kind of selling. Mostly only traders will be the one who will be doing this kind of selling. Now many people think like, oh my God, the price has been fallen from 14,740 levels to 14,621 levels. Maybe some FIIs might be selling, or maybe some DI might be selling. It could be an institutional selling, but let me tell you, let it be FII, let it be DI. At the end of the day, they are traders. They are not big investors. Because only traders are the one, they will be such micro-focused game. They are precisely, they took the price to that level. And even better, you can see that the B and the F period lows are precisely same. So all these are again a micro-focused levels. Precisely one of the intraday targets. If at all prices, you're anticipating a selling, that B and F period could be one of the potential targets. So again, this is one information I have to carry forward for Monday because it is a precise level. It's a weaker level. It's a microscopic level that I have to convert into a reference to manage my trades. If at all, let's say price is opening and it started doing some selling pressure, maybe that level could be one of my focus on the downside. If at all, there could be any selling pressure. So on Monday, there are a couple of levels that I've been focusing around from Monday's trading perspective. What we are having here is there is a poor reference which Nifty still failed to clear those levels this time. There are almost 5 anomalies we are having. So one anomaly here, second, third, fourth and fifth. So total 5 anomalies is what we are having. So what we can anticipate here is like if at all prices opening and then it's getting rejected over here, maybe the chances of hitting this is very high and the chances of going down is very higher. Immediately price could go down. This is one of the view that which I'm having. This is from an intraday perspective. If at all prices opening down below the prominent point of control, see that last Friday we are having a prominent point of control, a very symmetrical structure, no emotions on this particular, there are no emotions. However, this day is still filled with emotions, and that emotional levels are not cleared yet. Very rarely, these emotional levels may not fill at all. If at all markets are super strong in a trending markets, usually they may not fill at all. But if there is any possible rejections are happening, see that this level is weaker. This is one level weaker. We are having some more weaker levels on the downside. So my expectation on the downside is like, if at all any selling opportunity. So still we don't know really if selling opportunity can happen or not. Still can market can be totally bullish also. The market can be bullish if at all market start trading above the prominent point of control. You can see that one of the clues that we are getting here is like, we are getting a prominent point of control. Notice this particular prominent point of control. This prominent point of control is a weaker prominent point of control. This is what we call as a weaker prominent point of control. So usually this kind of prominent point of controls are there, this series. The chances of price returning back, though maybe a temporary selling can happen, usually the core focus, positional focus is still towards the 15,000 level. This is because I'm taking a macro level approach over here. This is not a microscopic approach. This is more of a macroscopic approach. Either two-way price can happen. This is only scenario number one. Scenario number one is like a price can clear this weaker levels and still it can go back and clear the poor structure also. This is one approach which I am having positionally. However, I'm also having an bullish case also. The bullish case is, let's say price started opening above the prominent point of control and one more straight drive. Price opens here, or something like price opens somewhere over here. It starts trading around and usually it starts moving towards the prominent point of control. This is going to be the, for this series, one can anticipate 15,500 again, back again. This is the current expectation from my perspective positionally. So how it's going to happen, whether there's going to be a dip again, it cheats the sellers, the price could pull back. Price could always cheat because there are still a lot of corona COVID numbers, you know, that every day it's been crazily increasing. So all these increasing numbers are only bringing only hopes to the sellers only. However, it is not getting materialized. Every time it is trying to materialize, markets are pulling back again repeatedly. All the drops in the markets, all these are mostly because of this COVID numbers only. Here there's a drop and then it provides a trading opportunity. Again, there was a big drop and again it was trying to provide a big trading opportunity only. So basically it is frustrating the sellers. So still, these markets are still very difficult to be a seller over here. Market can sell over here, but at this point of time, from a short-term perspective, is it selling off? That is a real question that one have to ask. That is like still the possibilities for the series are a bit lower. So 15,000 is again under the focus. So that is what I'm also expecting over here positionally. Now coming back to the topic here. Again, as I said, this one time framing is also one form of a reference level. So these are micro level focus levels. So what we'll be focusing is, we'll be focusing on a couple of topics over here from a micro level focus. If you ask me which are the things that I'll focus, one is I'll be focusing on weaker levels. A lot of weaker levels are there, approximately some 10 to 12 weaker levels that we can derive from a micro level focus. I'll be focusing on today's developing single print zone. This is not yesterday's, but today's. Today's, that is more of a micro level focus. Third one is today's point of control, developing point of control. We call this a developing point of control, developing value area. That is today's value area, today's point of control. And then one can also focus on the early morning high, early morning low. So which is like early morning high and early morning low. And probably if there is any yesterday's prominent point of control, price is going and rejecting or such kind of levels are there. Again, that can be a micro focus. And micro focus can also happen if there is any one time framing is happening. One time framing is a micro focus level, one time framing. So what else is there? So what else is there is like, So value area, if at all price is moving against the value area, one can see emotions. One can use this to measure the emotions, ongoing emotions in the markets. They can retrieve from these levels. Then, as I said, single print is also one form of a micro focus. What else is a micro focus? Today's point of control, we talked about that. Today's value area, we talked about that. Weaker levels, we talked about that. Yes. So another micro focus is not only today's point of control. If there's any prominent point of control, I had said about that. There are times the previous day high, previous day low, previous day high or previous day low, or multi-day high, multi-day high or low, multi-day high or low, or low. So these are micro focus in structure. For example, think about that. If you go to the Bank Nifty charts, you could have seen such kind of micro structures over here. So go to Bank Nifty. So I've been watching one of the visual levels, right? So we are having such kind of a levels over here. You can see this micro focus. So the high on 9th of April and the high of 6th April are precisely same, which is at 33,000, roughly around 33,200 levels. This is still a micro focus level. And that is what market could be gunning out for, probably another 2,200 points higher from the current levels. However, still, we are also having a some weaker level. Market had, there was a lot of anomalies are there. Some of the anomalies failed. It tried to clear. There's also a weaker point of control. This weaker point of control is also one form of a nuances. So there is a weaker W point of control is there. So that W point of control is also one form of an visual nuances, WPOC. Or if there is yesterday, if there is any poor structure, right? Poor structure, usually that is one form of an micro focus level. There are a lot of micro focus levels are there. Now, all these micro focus levels, it helps you to narrow down your thinking on what could be possible and why it is possible. So precisely most of the micro focus levels are on at a very trader level. It talks about how one should deal with those markets. Today's market, how I should deal and why I should trade a long or why I should trade a short. So that's what our market context is all about, right? It helps you to anticipate what could possibly happen in the markets. And more precisely, you have a reasoning why it should happen. So that is what market profile is all about. So in a simple term, what market profile helps you is that it helps you to understand what kind of traders are in control and which direction to trade, what is the overall market confidence, and whether the weaker hands, where the weaker hands are placing their trades, where the weaker hands are placing their stop loss levels. So one can easily go and able to identify from the market profile. And there's a why market profile is so useful. Peter Stadelmayer, who is the real inventor of market profile, he identified that recurring patterns happen in the floor. He physically went into the floor with a graph paper, and then he asked himself why they were occurring, that repeated structures, distribution structures. So that is why we got market profile as the end result. Market profile helps you to understand the present market situation, not only what happened in the past, but it also helps you to understand more better what is happening in the present. Many people, if you see, they'll give most importance only to the past information only. But only in market profile, we give importance to the past information also. But even better than that, we give more importance to the what is happening in the present market condition. We give more importance to the present. We also give importance to the past, but more importance we give to the what is happening right now. So that is what it helps you to take a better trading decision. However, it is more of an art. And it gives more clarity in thinking about what is happening in the markets. It helps traders to know how traders behave in the markets. It helps the traders to understand the ongoing trading sentiment. So it gives you a 360 degree about what is exactly happening inside the markets. Markets as a crowd, are they doing a good job? Are they doing a bad job? So here are some of the terminologies we use. Initial balance, which is nothing but the first 1 hour high and low. Then we have point of control. Point of control talks about what? Where more times the letters has been traded. And then value area, where 70% of the trading activity is happening. Buying tail and selling tail. And of course, single prints, we learned about that. Early morning high and low, which is nothing but the first letter period, A period, high and low. Now, generally, these are the things which comprise to become a market profile. However, there is a separate distinction between price action and price distribution. So this is a price action of last couple of days activity. So from the price action, it is very difficult to derive the nuances. Some people say like price is king. However, I would say like price distribution, if price is king, then price distribution is more of an emperor. That means what? Price distribution not only talks about price action, but more than that, it gives an importance to the price distribution also. As a trader, one has to learn to give more importance to how much ever importance they are giving to price action, they should also give equivalent amount of price distribution. Because if you watch only price, there are heavy chances are there that if you watch only price, you may take emotional decision, which you don't want to take. Sometimes traders will lose their focus on objectivity. They think markets are bearish, so they'll start trading the bearish markets. So only if you watch the price distribution with the micro focus level, then only they can shift their focus. They can confidently, they can go and trade a long, especially in a difficult situation like a COVID rise kind of situation where people are panicking and the price is going down. And despite that, you want to stop thinking on the downside, and trading on the long is not that easy unless your focus is a razor focus towards that micro data, micro generated information, where we focus on the nuances from the intraday perspective and we convert that nuances into trades. For that, price distribution will help you to analyze the structure here. And there's a small promo here. This time we are doing an Tradezilla 4.0, a complete 1 month event on market profile. Not only on market profile, we also focus on order flow and also how to combine market profile with some of our systematic trading indicators. So what we are planning to do this time is more of a fusion based approach, a kind of an approach using market profile, order flow, and also few indicators. Still, the approach is discretionary trading towards discretionary traders. So we're going to do we're going to use market profile for identifying the intraday targets. And we're going to use to time the trades. We're going to use trading signals to time the trades, to time the entry points at times, and at times to time our exit. We will be using the trading signals. So that is what we're going to do in Tradezilla 4.0. If you want to know about the complete details, probably you can go to tradezilla.co. Tradezilla.co. So where you can go and get more details about the syllabus, about the content. This time we are extensively talking about various new approach towards trading. Most of our approaches are modern approach, not a legacy, very old classical style analysis. So all the, what are the market profile strategies that we are talking, you can go and see it over here. So point of control based strategies. So what are the strategies that we are discussing, and exclusively order flow strategies. What are the strategies that we are covering under market on this order flow strategies? What are the strategies that we've been covering on the particularly on order flow, what kind of strategies that we have been covering? Most of the strategies are from the intraday perspective. And close to close, we are covering 20 strategies this time in order flow alone. And market profile, we are close to close. We're going to cover 30 plus intraday trading strategies is what we're going to cover, which can be applied on a regular day-to-day based trading here. And the session itself goes for almost 75 hours, right? So 75 hours of content. At times it can go beyond that also, depends upon the participation interest anywhere between 75 hours to 85 hours is what one can anticipate. Some learning happens on the weekends, but majority of the learnings happens during the live markets. So 40 plus hours of live training session is what we're going to do. And then rest of the learnings will be on the weekends only. Saturdays, Sundays, we'll be having the learning. And yes, one will be having a lifetime access to the Slack. So to our Slack community, they can get a lifetime access. And all the programs recording access will be available to our traders. Not only that, so this 70, along with the 75 plus hours of training, the participants will also get access to the our own proprietary trading indicators as well. Along with that, they also get access to 75, another 75 plus hours of our previous TradeZilla. So our TradeZilla, what kind of approaches that we had taken in a different market conditions, what approaches we had taken. So all those examples will be quoted during the live markets only. So we'll be quoting mostly the live example, the nearest example, whichever happened in the last 1 year or so. And what is the recent example, which is right now it is happening. We not only quote examples from the past, we also quote examples from the present as well. And especially some of the trades we'll be showing you using the tools like some of the option tools. So we'll be using Opstra for showing the trades. So we'll be showing some of the live trades, why I had taken such kind of trades. For example, the Nifty intraday strategy, which happened over here. So why I had taken this particular strategy, when I had taken and what time I had closed, what kind of, how I had done, executed this hedge trades, and what are the other trades that we had done. And all those examples will be explained with trades, right? Why I had taken this trade, what made me to enter this trade, what made me to exit this trade, all those analysis will be explained using the Opstra kind of tools. All the trades I will be recording live in the Opstra tool, and which I'll be explaining with nuances. Why I'm taking this trade, why I'm closing this trade will be explained during the live session itself. So I guess you right now you have some sort of understanding about how to use market profile from a microscopic perspective. However, in TradeZilla 4.0, we'll be giving more importance to both macroscopic perspective as well as microscopic perspective as well. However, the focus is mostly on directional trades. So even if you are trading with options also, we'll be taking a couple of option trading approaches, mostly on the hedged side, when to take an hedged approach, when not to take an hedged approach. So all those things we will be discussing in TradeZilla 4.0. So let me know if you have any questions. I can take it over here. So Shubham is talking about, it says like there are two packages which is available. One is TradeZilla 4.0 with trial and without trial. So one is like, we're also providing a complimentary paid trial for a Bell TPO software. If you are already having a software, or if you don't, if you're already having a software elsewhere, you can use your own tools. In my case, I've been using mostly Bell TPO as a tool. So if in case, if you want to subscribe for a paid trial, there is also a package which is available in TradeZilla with 1 month of paid trial over there. There's a different package to that. Yeah, so you can, if you want to subscribe, you can always go to Febinars platform. So under, go to Febinars.com, you can go to the courses section. You can see the complete agenda, which is available under the TradeZilla 4.0. You can go and see the complete description, what kind of strategies are covered. It is a highly elaborated section. I can guarantee you only one learning here. I can guarantee you, we don't promise anything on the numbers. So if you trade this, you will achieve 100% in a year, 50% in a year. We don't guarantee any such numbers, because you know that that is totally against the policies of SEBI. So, but what I can guarantee you one thing over here, I can guarantee you an institutional grade technical analysis program, especially if you want to become a full-time trader, or if you are aspiring to become a full-time trader, I can give you a proper knowledge at an institutional grade In fact, I had trained various institutions on market profile, on systematic trading and order flow. So I can totally guarantee you on deeper insights on market profile and market profile based strategies and order flow strategies. I can help you traders on trying to achieve objectivity and to take an emotionless trading with a good confidence. So the confidence building is what one thing that you will be learning in our course. So complete details, you can go and find in the section over here. What are the things that we've been covering? What access that you'll be getting? What are the benefits that you'll be getting over here? Complete pricing details, everything you can go and learn over here. Primarily, we'll be using tools like AmiBroker and NinjaTrader are the two primary tools we are going to use throughout the session. We're going to use both AmiBroker and NinjaTrader over here. So can we ask questions live? Yes, anytime you can unmute and you can speak back in TradeZillal 4.0. So you can ask one-on-one questions also. So we'll be having a separate Q&A session. Every time we are having a break, right? Before the break or after the break, we'll be having a Q&A session. And even at the end of the session also, one can go and ask any number of questions. And even after that, if you want to ask questions, so we are providing a Slack platform, which the access is for the lifetime. So you can ask any number of questions, any number of time in our Slack platform. And that commitment that what we are providing is a lifetime access. So Mohit is asking, is it from very basics? So yes, definitely we'll be starting from the basics only. But what we had done this time is we are providing one more access to the course, to the basic course. If in case more detailed, elaborated basics, if you want, right? We had done a mini certification course on market profile. So we are requesting all the participants of TradeZilla, right, to complete the certification before coming into the program. So this course will be available as a complimentary to the traders. So generally it is the one which covers the very basics of market profile, basics of how you should see the markets at a very macro perspective. It has been covered. But what you can find in our courses, more than a macro focus, we also cover macro focus. We cover from a positional trading perspective, we'll be covering in TradeZilla. And the microscopic perspective, we'll be covering mostly from the intraday perspective. Yeah, so yes, definitely everything will be right from the basics only. However, in-depth basics, the whatever is there in the textbook style analysis, everything covered will be covered in this particular course. End of this course, you will be getting a certificate from a certification mini course on not only on market profile, even the course completion certificate on TradeZilla 4.0 also, one will be getting it after completing all the online modules. So Pradeep is asking, after training, kindly also do hand holding as market profile is having so many concepts. So what we do is we also continuously doing every Friday, we are doing sessions. There are many days we are doing market profile sessions. And there are times we do community webinar sessions. So a lot of community webinars that we had done in the past also, and we'll be doing it in our future sessions also. And whenever there's any events, we do event session, like whenever there's an RBA policy announcement, we'll be doing a session. Whenever there's a budget, we'll do session for our students. So particularly on those complex days, how to use market profile to identify trading opportunities, especially on event days, we do such kind of live session, and that commitment also we are providing to our students as a lifetime commitment. So you do explain market profile on live session, not recorded. So of course, Sanjay, I had done various live sessions also. So if you want to go and see the live sessions with some of the live sessions which I had presented, right, you can go back and check it out. In fact, most of our sessions are live, and which will be already we presented most of our live sessions in the YouTube channel as well. If you haven't subscribed to the YouTube channel, you can always go to youtube.com/user/marketcalls. Here you can go and check out some of our market profile live sessions, which I had already presented over here. You can go to the playlist section And here you can go and check out all those market profile related videos over here. So far I had posted 52 sessions over here. Some of them are live, some of them are recorded, right? Yeah, recording, you know that anybody can tell a story over here. So I'm not here to do any storytelling competition. However, some of the live sessions that you can see in this particular session, you can go back and check it out. All those live sessions which I had done in the past, right? Which is available over there. And yes, Tradezilla 4.0, we are still covering 40 plus hours, 1 hour in the morning and 1 hour in the afternoon. We are totally covering live sessions on market profile, not only on market profile, but also from order flow, from also from system trading perspective also. We are extensively covering about that. So Deepak question is, on 12th, was there rally high which can be taken as an intraday reference? Yes, on 12th, there was a rally high, which we had taken as an intraday reference as well. There was a rally high. So Sanjay is saying recording seems enticing, but live helps. Of course, see, not everything we cannot do it live. There are times, there are some basics we need to thought. If I'm going to do the basic session during the live markets, I feel like it is not a good idea. That is the reason all the basic theoretical part we'll be doing in the weekend session. And live is mostly, we'll be talking about strategies only. Only talking about strategies, current market situations, how to prepare for the markets. That is how this session has been totally focused towards that. All right, great. So let me stop the session here. I hope you got some meaningful insights about market profile. Next week, what we are going to do is we're going to look into order flow, what one can learn from order flow, and what is the importance of order flow, how one can combine market profile with order flow, and how one can extract meaningful information about order flow is what we're going to discuss in the next Saturday session. Stay tuned to Febinars. I hope you all had downloaded the Febinars app platform. You can also you can also access your course from the Febinars Android app as well. If in case if you haven't downloaded, you can go to the Google Play Store, download the Febinars app plan, Febinars platform, and you can access the course from the mobile app as well. So thank you for coming by once again, and stay tuned for the next week webinar. Thank you. So Jay Singh is asking about my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel, you can get it from here. So youtube.com/user/market calls. All right. So this is my YouTube channel. Anyways, I'll be posting the link here also. Here's the link I also posted, youtube.com/user/market calls. Anyways, I thank you once again for coming by and spending your Sunday along with us. Thank you once again.